Hello everyone, this is Umair Hassan and you are watching CSS GSA lecture series. Today we are going to discuss about the concept of averages, that is mean, median, mod. Well, you can also term it as measure of central tendency. So we are going to study about mean, median and mod, and that is for ungrouped data. For group data, the process is quite different. As far as mean, median, mod is concerned, so you basically use these averages to evaluate your data, to analyze your data. More proper word will be to analyze your data, and which average is the better average. That depends on condition of the given question. So we are going to discuss how to calculate mean, median, mod. We will also discuss which average is better in all these three. So what is mean? Mean is basically sum of all the values divided by number of values. I will explain it with the help of a question. The second one is median. Median is usually the middle value. And the third one is mod. Mod is most popular value. Mod is most frequently occurring value. So let us take a question. The shoe sizes of 19 students in a class are shown below. They are the shoe size of 19 students. So calculate mean size, mean shoe size, median shoe size, and most popular shoe size. Well, as you know, mean is sum of all the values. So add all the shoe sizes divided by number of values. So they are 19 in number. So when you will add all the shoe sizes, they will add up to 115 divided by number of values. These values are 19 in total. So 115 over 19 is 6.05. Well, this is mean shoe size. Well, there will not be any shoe having a size of 6.05, but this value tells you that your data, your shoe sizes are somewhere below or above this value. So they will be spread around this value. So this is an approximation about the shoe size. Median shoe size, okay, median is the middle value. And if you want to calculate the middle value, you need to arrange your data in ascending order. Ascending order means the smaller shoe size will be written at first. And in this way, you will increase the shoe size from small to large. This is the smallest shoe size and this is the largest shoe size. So arrange them in ascending order. After arranging them in ascending order, there are different techniques to calculate the middle value. You can simply calculate the middle term. Well, total values are 19. So the middle term is the term from where before that you have 9 values and after that you have 9 values. 9 and 9, 18, plus the middle one, that is 19. So middle value is the value which have same number of values before and after it. But there is a formula if you want to calculate the position of your middle number, that is n plus 1 by 2. N is total number of values, n is 19, total number of values. So 19 plus 1 is 20 by 2, that is 10. This 10 is not mean, median. This 10 is not median. This is the position of your median. 10th position is the position where your median is present. So calculate your position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is your 10th position where your median is present. So your median shoe size is 6. You can use the same formula for odd number of values. We have 19 values, which is odd. Similarly, you can calculate for even number of values. For even number of values, if we have been given with 20 shoe sizes, then the values are even. Mean 20 shoe sizes, 20 is even. For that, you will be having two numbers. At the middle position, we will be having two values and the average of those two will be the answer. Last one is the mod. Mod is most popular value, most frequently occurring value. So in this data, in this shoe sizes. Which shoe size is the most frequent, most popular? Well, that is 6. So if you compare mean, median, mod, mean is 6.05, median is 6, and mod is 6. So all these three averages gives us roughly the same value. So let us take an example when there will be limitation of mean, when mean will not be the best one to use. So let us take an example. So this is about the concept of averages. So take this example. The following are the speeds of car passing a particular house over a 5-minute period: 67.2 km per hour, 58.3 km per hour, 128.9 km per hour, 65.0 km per hour, 49.7 and 55.7. Now this one is odd one out. That means this one is basically not the one like the other car have the speeds over here. This one is excessive, a large value. You may call it an extreme value. In this case, your mean, a mean will not be the most suitable average. The reason is that if you will calculate the mean by summing all the values divided by number of values, so your answer will be 70.8 km per hour. Well, this 70.8 doesn't represent all of this data. Your mean should be a value, or average is basically a value that tells you about the spread, that your values are spread around this value. Your values, your data set values should spread around your mean, but this is quite large as compared to rest of them. So for this case, when you have extreme values in your observation, mean may not be the most suitable answer. Now if you will calculate the median, median is basically the middle value. Arrange your values in ascending order: 49.7 smallest value at the beginning, biggest value at the end. Your number of values are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 values. So when your number of values are even, use the formula n plus 1 by 2. N plus 1 by 2 to find the position of your median. N is 6. Number of values are 6 plus 1 by 2 is 7 over 2, which is 3.5. 3.5 is your position where your median is present. 1 position, 2 position, 3 position, 4 position. Where is 3.5? Exactly in the middle. 3.5 means between 3 and 4. So if you want to find position between 3rd and 4th one, between 3rd position and 4th position, the middle of that is add them, add 3rd value and 4th value and divide them by 2. Add 3rd value and 4th value, divide them by 2, you will get your median, which is at this position. So when you have even number of values, you can find median in this way. So this is how you are going to find mean, median, mod, and that is also known as measure of central tendency. So in my next video, I will talk about the rest of the concept regarding this topic. So keep watching. Thank you so much.